We all know that mermaids are real, but did you know that the sea around the coast of Cornwall is home to a great number of lesser-known mythical beings? This is the tale of a lonely and sometimes frightening creature, the sea bucca of Lamorna Cove. Cornwall is home to a myriad of mysterious fairy-like creatures. From piskies to knockers to spriggans, these beings are well known for their mischievous tricks and sometimes unpredictable kindness. One such creature is a bucca, a sort of sea-dwelling water spirit. Buccas can often be found perched on rocks with the birds or inside sea caves. Along the jagged cliffs west of Penzance, past the more established ports of Newlyn and Mousel, there is a tiny fishing cove called Lamorna. This is where one such sea bucca is known to live. The story goes that he was once a handsome prince who, for reasons unexplained, was cursed by a witch. This curse caused him to turn into a bucca. No longer was the prince handsome, instead he had the skin of a conger eel. What was once flowing locks of hair on his head was now a mess of tangled seaweed. The sea bucca was unpredictable in his interactions with the locals and would often fly into a terrible rage, looking to bring awful vengeance on anybody that crossed him. For this reason, the Lamorna villagers would stay away. This left the sea bucca a lonely, wretched creature, living a life of solitude with only the seagulls for company. While the sea bucca was a terrifying creature to the fishermen who inhabited Lamorna Cove, he loved the local children, who he could hear playing on the beach at low tide. Maybe the sound of their cheerful games reminded him of his own happy human childhood before he was cursed. Without the village fishermen being successful with their catch, the children of Lamorna would go hungry. So when the fishermen were in their boats, the sea bucca would swim nearby, driving fish into their nets and crabs into their pots. To thank the bucca for his service to the community, and possibly to placate him lest he fly into another rage, fishermen would leave a share of their catch for the bucca in the harbour. The fishing boats from Lamorna have now long gone. While there may be the occasional vessel from a neighbouring fishing port passing by, there are no longer any Lamorna fishermen left for the sea bucca to help with their catch. You can still often catch glimpses of him in the waves, however. It's best not to get too close to him, though, his rage about his situation having not dimmed over the years. If you ever happen to be passing through Lamorna Cove, it's worth remembering the service the sea bucca offered this small community for so many years. If you can spare it, leave him an offering of some fish and listen to him splashing in the waves, forever solitary and alone.